Welcome back to Genetics 101. Today we have a Siamese sable. She's kind of poorly marked. She is a mini lop out in the play area today. She just got done with her litter, and so she's back to freedom for a little while from having kits, but she loves to come out and play, and so figure let her come out today. But we're going to talk about the next locus point that we have here. And that next locus point is the SI locus. Now, we're getting closer to the end of this of the string here. If you have not watched the videos previously for the A through EN locus, I highly recommend that you go back and watch those and start from the beginning. Because these first five and six are, you're going to run into those the most often. These later ones you're not going to run into very often, and there are some of them are going to be very breed specific. So the SI locus is responsible for the silvering that we see on the, or the ticking, the silver ticking we see on the ends of the hairs of a particular color. One of those, and it's highly breed specific. So if you're working in one of the Argent breeds, the Creme d'Argents is just an example. The Argent Brune, all those, that's very breed specific, and those colors are created by this locus point. Now, there is a push to create champagnes in Netherland Dwarf. Champagne d'Argent is another breed that uses this gene, but in Netherland Dwarf, it's still being worked on. Okay, because it can present in several ways with things such as mid champagnes where they're not fully covered in the ticking. Or the silvering that comes, they are all born black, and that silvering comes in as they get closer to adulthood. It is a lot of work to get these colors approved, so we've been working on those. I do not have any at this time. We are working on getting a breed pair in the Netherlands to start working on that color, as it's probably going to hopefully be approved in the next couple of years. In Netherland Dwarf, but it takes a lot of time and a lot of work to get that process going. But as far as the genetic side of it, we're talking about the SI locus. There are only two alleles that take place at this locus point. We have capital SI, which results in no effect. It is also the dominant allele, and then we also have the lowercase SI for silvering, and that means that the silvering is created by the recessive allele. And as we've learned in previous loci points, the only time that you will see the color actually present in your rabbit is if you have two copies of a recessive present. So for, like we learned in the A locus, the only way you get a self to actually present in the color of your rabbit as a self color, self base color, you have to have two copies of that self allele, which is also the most recessive at A. It's the same way with the silvering here. So we only have two combinations for silvering to be presented or not. Or three different combinations of alleles. We could have two capital SIs. We're not going to get any silvering out of that. We could get a capital SI and a lowercase SI. We're still not going to get any silvering out of that because, again, remember, dominant alleles at each locus point are going to be what actually modifies or changes the color of the rabbit. Okay? Recessives will not present. Okay? And we're not going to get into advanced genetics and incomplete dominance here. We're talking about just the general introduction to genetics here. So we're not going to get any silvering by doing that. The only way we're going to get silvering is if we have two recessive copies of the silvering allele to present in our rabbit. I really wish I had a rabbit to show you that was in this color, because they are absolutely gorgeous. But you can go on YouTube, you can go on online, anywhere, and look at the look up Netherlandorf champagnes, and you'll see what we're talking about in regards to the coloring, and or look up Champagne de Argence and look at the coloring of those as well. I think we have a picture on the website as well at flatwabbitrabbitry.com under the genetics section of an actual Champagne d'Argent. So you can take a look at that or do some looking around online. I'm sure you'll find tons of pictures of these guys. There's so many. They're just a really unique color, and hopefully we hope to have a few of those in Netherlandorf. Hopefully by the end of this year, and start actually be working on production of those in 2019, and then hopefully have some available by 2020. So that's this Locus Point. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We're going to cover the next Locus Point, which is the Dutch, the DU Locus Point. And I think that one will be interesting. We're going to go do that one next, and then we'll get into Lutino and wideband, and then all we'll have left after that is Vienna. So stay tuned, and we'll see you at the next episode.